The browser company continues to be one of the most interesting startups we cover, I think. And no, again, I am not an investor, full disclosure. But the startup behind the Arc web browser and more recently Arc Search announced what they called Act 2 of their company today. In fact, what they're calling a new category of software. They did a bit of Steve Jobs announcing the iPhone callback. It's a web browser, a search engine, and even web pages themselves all in one. Basically, they continue to do this mission of you tell Arc what to do and it will go out on the internet and do it for you. The interesting new features they announced included what they're calling instant links for when you know exactly what you want. Quoting The Verge, the new instant links feature is a way to use AI to skip a search engine. If you're looking for something specific, like that epic blank space performance from Taylor Swift's Sydney stop on the 1989 World Tour, you can just ask Arc's AI bot for it, and it'll dump that link in an open tab into your sidebar. The browser company also suggests grabbing a bunch of product reviews for your comparison or some good-sounding recipes. Anytime you might go to Google and click the first 8 links, Arc can just dump those links into your tab bar, end quote. And quoting MacStories, this feature uses large language models as Arc goes out and browses for you to return the results. But a critical point here is that at no point does a search engine appear on screen, effectively cutting someone like Google out of the picture. How accurate this feature can be remains to be seen, but if it does what it promises, it should make finding things you want much quicker, end quote. That's available today on the Arc browser. The next new thing isn't coming until the 15th, but it's something they called live folders. With this, it's almost like they're bringing back RSS feeds and Google Reader and everything from 2008. Essentially, these are live data streams that live in the sidebar of your browser. So if I want to get updated every time there's news on, say, the browser company, there's a Google Alert style section you can go to catch up. These can even be actual pings. In the video, they mentioned that if you get tagged in GitHub or Linear, you can have a tab pop up that gets your attention, almost like bringing Slack into the browser where you're working. They put the call out for other companies and developers to work with them to build out this feature too. The third thing was something they called Arc Explore that seems to build off that Browse For Me button in their Arc Search iOS app, quoting MacStories again. Arc Explore is the same as Browse For Me, but taken to its logical next step. After the personalized web page of results is generated, you will be able to ask follow-up questions or query parts of the summary that you want to learn more about. This works conversationally, which is very different from how we currently search for something. You scan the results, tap for more, or search again, rinse and repeat. The demo of this is impressive, but Miller did note that this isn't the finished form and no date has been set for this feature. Even the name isn't final, end quote. Again, the analogy I would make here is, what if you could go to ChatGPT and collaboratively work with the bot to browse the web? Like a personal web browsing butler? Anyone remember Ask Jeeves? Web browser, web pages, search engine, they're putting it all behind their web browser app. That ceases to be a web browser in a way, and almost is closer to what we're imagining these AI agents to be like someday eventually. Replacing Google with a Perplexity-style AI search engine that lives inside of their cross-platform Chrome killer, as our friend Chris Messina put it. The browser company went hard at Google in their announced video. They mentioned SEO stuffed spam pages. They mentioned how the web is breaking up into pieces, just like we've been talking about on the show. They specifically name-checked the LLM and AI moment as the reason why the web can be remade right now. But again, is the web going to be remade by essentially obviating away the constituent parts of the web? Is that what we want?